kind of amazing that I was not expecting. Now, this Model X, my 75D Model X, is currently charging at 127 kilowatt. Now, this Model X, when I bought it 4 months ago, was limited to 94 kilowatt charge rate. This was one of the Teslas that were limited because Tesla determined that the previous owner, DC fast charged too much. Now, my Model S is also capped at 94, and it has been since the second month I owned it. Well, in a software update about 3 weeks ago, it brought my supercharging speeds up to about 105, and occasionally 108. But only for about a minute, maybe 2 minutes at a time. Now, I got a software update last week, and what are we on? We're on. Come on. Firmware 9, 2019.20.4.2, and I supercharged a few times last week. I actually, on this exact firmware, on the exact same stall here in Oak Creek Supercharger in Oak Creek, Wisconsin, Milwaukee County, I couldn't get over 40 kilowatt charge rate. In fact, I couldn't get over 40 on any of these, even though the pack was cool and everything was nice and amazing there. But as you saw, I was over 130. I got to look back at the video because my brain is just toast tonight, what my actual charge speeds were. But holy crap, I'm going to have to repeat this again, I'm going to have to get the cable out of my, Model S, but look at the CAN bus data while we're doing this charge, if I can hit this again. But, I'm just now hearing the air conditioner compressor spooling up, and so that means cooling's going to really start kicking in here. This is exciting. I mean, this is awesome. Now, factory charge speed, when this 75D was brand new, some of them were top sped out at about 105, and some of them had a top speed charge rate of 115, 114, 115. Likewise with the original 60 packs. So this is blowing my mind now that I'm finally getting to see this. I'd love to try it and have it on have the faster speeds on my Model S, but my Model S is still on firmware 8.1, and I am not changing that anytime soon. And close my window, the skeeters are getting in. And as the charge speed is now dropping, and I'm hearing the air conditioning system spooling up faster and faster to cool the battery pack and car systems, it just continues to drop. So I am pretty much guessing right now that the cells in the battery are heating up, and which is why charge rate is now going down. But that is amazing. Look at that. Time remaining, it guesstimates 50 minutes to a 100% charge, which I already know is a bunch of bull and is not going to happen. But, and yes, I always leave my slider at 100%, even though I rarely get over 85 or 90. That's just in case I get out, go somewhere like Chick-fil-A or grab something to eat or grocery shopping and it takes me a little longer. I don't have to worry about coming back and or forgetting to set that charge slider and have to pay idle fees. Ha ha! 109, 108. This is impressive. Now, the last time I got 108, I started with a pretty much dead battery. And when it got up to 108, it stayed there for about 2 minutes before dropping down to about 50. So, impressive. Good night, everybody.